Hey everybody, Dr. Eric Plasker here. Welcome to this weekly 100. Happy holidays to everybody. So excited about the season and wishing you and your family all the best. And I want to start this weekly 100 with a poem. And it goes like this. If you want to perform at the top of your game, eat healthy foods and take care of your frame. The choices you make will direct your innate to a life of decay or an optimum state. Take care of your body, your mind, and your spine. Make healthy choices that keep you in line. You've got to have nerve to adjust to it all. Your 100 is coming. You make the call. That motivates me. I hope it motivates you. I want to go through it, though, a little bit because there's a lot in here. There's a lot of meaning behind it. If you want to perform at the top of your game, the choices that you make in what you eat, how you take care of your body, your spine, your nervous system, your health, all important, because what they do is your choices, listen carefully now, your choices direct your innate intelligence, your body's inborn wisdom to either decay or become optimum in function on every level. Here's an example of that. If your innate did not adapt, did not have the equipment to adapt, when I say innate, that intelligence within you, your body's innate intelligence, if it did not have the ability to adapt, what would happen if you ate too much and ate too much and ate too much without exercising and you ate the wrong foods and you kept eating and kept eating and kept eating? Well, you wouldn't explode blood and guts all over the place, all over the walls. That wouldn't happen. What would happen is your body would think, your body's innate intelligence and its wisdom trying to keep you alive and functioning, it would add extra pounds. And the more that you ate that was overeating, the more extra pounds that you would get added to your body. So your body adapts, and it's a good thing it adapts, because the consequence of not adapting is that you would probably deteriorate, decay, and probably die right there on the spot, which would not be funny, of course, but that's what would happen. And the same thing happens when we see it with a lot of our patients, where their spine is out of alignment, their nervous system has been injured, and their body adapts. Instead of just collapsing and falling to the ground, the body adapts. It starts to lay down new bone, which when we look at films, x-rays, we see deterioration and decay, which also affects the function of the body, which affects the nervous system. So your body's innate intelligence has the ability to adapt, and it's going to adapt based on your choices. So eat healthy foods and take care of your frame, because the choices you make are going to direct your innate. And it's important to think this way, because when you change your life and adapt back, let's say you start making healthy choices again, let's say you start eating healthy, you start exercising, you align your spine, get adjusted, keep your body functioning the way that it's supposed to, your body adapts back. So you can lose that weight. Not that it was yours to begin with. It's interesting, a lot of people don't know this, but 15 years ago, I weighed 50 pounds heavier than I do today. And when I looked at my life back then, I gained, like a lot of you maybe, I had gained 3 pounds a year over 15 years after I got married. So I put on 45 to 50 pounds, not all at one time, but because I embraced this lifestyle that was not the 100-year lifestyle, of course, but was more of a 50-year rot away, deteriorate, decay, be unhealthy lifestyle. And so I changed back, and within a year it was gone, and then it's been gone ever since. We've kept it off. Why? Because I changed my life, because I realized that if I want to perform at the top of my game, the choices are going to direct, my choices will direct my innate, just like your choices will direct yours. And it's important to make these choices and think about it for the long haul. There's an article that just came out in last week's Time magazine. It has the 25 best inventions on the cover. This article was given to me by a good friend of mine, Dr. David Melendez, one of our 100-year lifestyle affiliate chiropractors out there in right outside of San Diego. And it talks about dignity and death, dignity, death, and America's crisis in elder care. What it says here is really important for us to understand, and we've talked about it in our weekly 100s in the past, that there is a growing dependency as baby boomers enter their twilight years. They will require, according to this article, not necessarily, they will require more health services and facilities like nursing homes. What it says, in 2010, the number of Americans age 65 and older were 40.3 million. The number of elderly people per every 100 working age people is 21 out of every 100. And in 2040, the projected number of Americans age 65 and older is 79.7 million people. Now, this number is a significant number. And listen, if you're younger than this, and probably a lot of you listening, or maybe you're in your 20s, maybe you're in your teens, maybe you're in your 30s and 40s, you realize that if you have aging parents and grandparents and great-grandparents, you realize that many of them, most of them, did not think they were going to live this long, so they didn't know how to take care of themselves to ensure a quality of life as they age. So they are dependent on medical care, organ removal, services to keep them alive, many of them, not necessarily doing the things, living a lifestyle that keeps them healthy, what we call the 100-year lifestyle. And so it's important that you understand, if you are in your teens, 20s, 30s, 40s, or 50s, if you have aging parents and grandparents, that you have an opportunity to make choices that are good for you, not just for today, but will also be good for you over the long haul. I want you to think about this for a minute. There's an article, a couple of articles that we just posted on this fan page on. One is on steer clear of cardiac rehab, another one on sick, fit people. We posted them from 100yearlifestyle.com. These are really important articles because what they talk about is what's the difference between cardiac rehab and personal training. Here's the answer. It's an interesting answer. The answer is, can you think about it for a minute? The difference between cardiac rehab and personal training? What's the answer? The answer is time, when it happens, either before or after the heart attack. And so if you understand that and you realize that if you're in a position right now to make choices that are good for your heart, that are good for your spine, that are good for your nervous system, that are good for your mind, that are good for your whole body today and make them your lifestyle, then you can avoid in the future needing cardiac rehab, developing heart problems because you're keeping yourself healthy. Interesting thing happened just recently, and I'm going to do a product review in just a minute on the Fitbit, which I have. I'm wearing it right now, so we're going to get to that in just a minute. Just recently, I had a blood test taken for a new life insurance policy that I was going to get. And what was interesting about it, the same doctor that tested me 30 years ago when I was 25 years old, tested me for this one now at 55 years old. And he asked me these questions that he was blown away by the answers. He asked me, so Dr. Plasker, tell me, what conditions and diseases do you have in your medical history? And I said, Dr. Bob, I don't have a medical history. What do you mean? What symptoms, what diseases? Well, I don't have them. Well, what medications are you on? Most people your age are on blood pressure drugs, they're on cholesterol drugs, and they're on antidepressants, many of them, and they're on anxiety medications. So they're on 3 or 4 or 5 medications. What medications are you on? And the answer is none. I'm not on any medications. I don't have that medical history. And he said to me, because it was very interesting and it's important, I want to share it with you, because he said to me, you know, Dr. Plasker, when I tested you 30 years ago and you came in and you were a practicing chiropractor with this lifestyle consciousness that you were bringing to the city of Atlanta and Marietta, I quite honestly, as a medical doctor, I thought you were out of your mind. And now, looking at your health, your blood pressure, 110 over 70, your pulse 60, your healthy, you're not on any medication. Do you know how many people I see that are 55 years old that are not on any medication? And I said, I have no idea, Dr. Bob, tell me. And he said, zero. They're all on medications. And I used to think you were a maniac, but you know what? This is inspiring for me, just like it's probably going to be inspiring for you that you're doing so well. And of course, there's going to be no problem getting this life insurance policy. And you know what? I think I may want to change my life as well based on a lot of the things that we're talking about, which is the things that we're talking about on this particular live session. And so it's important that you understand that the choices that you make will direct your innate. So even if you've gone down a bad path, then you could take a different path. And right now, starting with the holidays, begin to make healthier gift giving, healthier choices before the holidays. Make that your norm. Make the life changes that you want to make before the holidays, not after the holidays. You know, traditionally, we blow it out. We blow it out with way too much sugar and way too much food. And then we put on an extra 5 pounds and we start an extra 5 pounds behind the eight ball. And what happens is we start January 1st and we say, well, I'm going to change my life, and we do it for a month. No, you can start changing your life right now with healthy gift giving. I want to give you a review on this one product that I actually really like. It's called the Fitbit, and you're seeing it everywhere right now. And just recently, my wife and I, we went to Italy. We went with Life University. We wanted to, we spoke to a lot of prospective students out there who are thinking about a career in chiropractic and nutrition and positive psychology and just holistic types of living. And it was a great session. And then we had a great seminar for doctors teaching about them about these particular principles. And so I wanted to see how much walking I was going to be doing. And so I got the Fitbit just to track my walking. And you know what? You can get a lot of products that do that. But I really kind of like this Fitbit. They came out with this new one called the Ionic. And it's like a watch. You can see it. I'll hold it up closer. You could change the head to be anything you want it to be. And it tracks your steps. It tracks your heart rate. It tracks your sleep, your quality of sleep. And it is, I believe, a very, very good product. And so if you want to begin to monitor yourself and get a gift over the holidays that is going to be good for you, that will set you up to win after the first of the year, this is a great holiday gift that you can get, a healthy gift that will get you on track and keep you on track to have a great quality of life now and also to help you as you age. Some additional healthy gifts that you might want to think about giving. There's a lot of you that are going to be joining gyms or thinking about joining gyms or CrossFit centers or Pilates studios or so many different types of different fitness facilities, personal training sessions. What a great gift that you can give somebody or to ask for somebody to give to you to ensure that you get started on the right track. Another great gift, chiropractic checkups. There's a lot of you that have made that critical transition, as we say, from crisis care to lifestyle care, or you want to make that critical transition from crisis care to lifestyle care. You want to keep your spine balanced, your nervous system healthy. You don't want to wait for a crisis. You're sick and tired of living from crisis to crisis to crisis to crisis. You want to get ahead of the game. You want to change your life, and that way you know that your nervous system controls everything and that you need a healthy nervous system to function properly. And obviously a healthy spine can keep you active, not just for now, but as you age. And listen, a lot of people, when they start their fitness programs, what ends up happening is because they haven't taken care of their spine and nervous system, they have a very difficult time adapting to their workout programs because they get injured. Well, listen, if you include as a part of your gift giving some chiropractic examinations and checkups, that can make a difference for you to keep you on track after the first of the year. Hey, meditation. There are great meditation subscriptions that you can get to keep your body and your mind balanced and relaxed. I get fired up during these interviews and these live calls. It's a great gift that you can give to somebody or a great gift that you can ask for. Massage, also another great gift. I'll tell you what's a great gift. Get off the diet roller coaster. That doesn't work. One of the reasons why I believe I was able to change my life is I started cleansing instead of dieting. The difference between cleansing and dieting is cleansing is cleaning yourself out from the inside out by what you eat, eliminating stuff that doesn't belong on the inside because of what you eat. There are great products out there. One of our favorites is from Nutrigen. They have a cleansing program that I really like, Nutrigen.com. You can get it from there if you want to. There's other great ones out there if you want, and you could check it out. Standard Process also has a cleanse if you want to. There's great cleanses out there and a great gift to give somebody that wants to get track on the holidays. Another great trip if you want to, or gift, is if you want to take some great playtime in February, we have a trip coming up called Wild 100. We're doing it in Yellowstone National Park with Barrett Hedges. He's going to be our private guide. We're going to see it like you've never seen Yellowstone before, may never see it again in the winter. Spectacular, beautiful, magnificent, majestic. We're going to get some exercise walking around. We're going to have a private snow coach. We're going to take some great pictures, and it'll be a great, it'll be basically a 3.5-day mastermind for your life. If you want to live your ideal 100, your lifestyle, make some changes, make them permanent, take on your business, your professional life in a great way. We're going to mastermind about your business and your life for several days. And so you can check that out on this 100 Year Lifestyle fan page as well, or at Barehead Photography, bareheadphoto.com. And so, listen, it is time, my friends, if you want to make some changes, the choices that you make, if you want to perform at the top of your game, eat healthy foods, take care of your frame. The choices you make will direct your innate to a life of decay or an optimum state. Take care of your body, your mind, and your spine. make healthy choices that keep you in line. You've got to have nerve to adjust to it all. Your 100 is coming. You make the call. Thank you for being on this live show with me today. Enjoy it. Share it with your loved ones. Make a difference for the people in your life that you care about. And adjust your lifestyle, everybody. Live yours. Thanks for watching.